Hey, welcome back. In this video, we are going to deep dive into row and column widget. Because whenever you are making a Flutter app, there's going to be a time when you have to use row or a column widget. So it's very essential that you know them strongly. So hello developers, this is Radhika and you're watching Divine Coding. So let's get started. Okay, so till previous lessons, we were just using one single widget. But as we are preparing ourselves to create awesome and real world apps, so it's also important for us to know how to use multiple widgets. So for this purpose, we basically use two type of widgets, rows or column. So let me first start by showing you column. So to use column, we just need to type column. And in this case, as we are going to use multiple widgets, so instead of child, we will use children. Okay, so let's start by creating a container. And this time in child, instead of text widget, we will use Flutter logo widget. And now let's change the background color of our container. Let it be amber. And now let's give it some height, maybe 90 pixels. And then width also 90. So instead of creating containers three times, I will just copy it and then paste it twice. And now simply just change the colors like pink accent. And let's give it the color maybe purple. And as this is the last container, so we will try to make it a little larger. Okay, so now let me share some of the cool properties that our column has, like mean axis alignment and cross axis alignment. So you can understand this by having a look at this picture. So now let's see mean axis alignment in action. And then mean axis alignment. Just add a full stop. And here you can see all the options that you can use with it. So let's start by using center. So here you can see they are in the center of our main axis. And now let's use end. And here you can see they align themselves at the end. And now start. And now they are in the very top. And now let's use a space around. And now you can see they got a space around them. And now let's try space evenly. So here we can clearly see that there is an even space. And now what's left is space between. So this is what the main function of our main axis alignment. Now let's use cross axis alignment. And in the same way, start from capital letter and then full stop. And here you will see we have got a little different options like center, start, stretch, and many others. So let's start by using stretch. So here you can see our widgets got fully stretched. And now let's use start. And here you will notice one thing that first two widgets have aligned themselves to the starting point of the last widget, which is larger and bigger in the size. So in the same way, we will use center widget too. And here you will see they are in the center of the last widget, which is bigger and larger in the size. And in the same way, we will use end. Then too, you will notice they are at the end of this last container. So this is the quality that sets apart cross-axis alignment with the main axis alignment. So enough of experiment with our column widget. So let's move to the row widget. Okay, so let's just copy one container and delete the all until the column. And as we have created our column, in the same way, we have to create our row and then provide it children. And also add a trailing comma here. And now let's just paste our container. Or maybe paste it three times. And here you can clearly see what's the difference between a column and a row. In the case of our column, our children widgets were displayed in a vertical manner And in the row, our children widgets are being displayed in a horizontal manner. They basically share the same properties. Like row 2 have main axis and cross axis alignments. And now let's check how main axis alignment works in the case of row. And here you can see the same options that you can use, like end. And now let's use center. And here you can see it's now in center. And now let's use start. And then space evenly. And in the rows, you can clearly see the even space. And now let's use a space around. And here you can see a space around our widgets. And the last one which is left is a space between. So this thing is really going to be a very useful for us. And now let's move to our cross-axis alignment. And then cross-axis alignment dot. And again the same options. And now let's see center. So to see the difference, I will change the height. And this one I will change to 190. And now you can see it's in center. Now if I will use a start, and you can see it's in a start. And in the same way, end. They are basically all the same properties. And now it's time for a stretch. So now I think row and columns are very clear to you. So these widgets are really very important. So I want you to have a little bit practice with them. So that's it for today's video. If you learn anything from this video, then make sure to hit the like button. And also let me know in the comment section what you want to learn next. And if you haven't subscribed till now, then make sure to hit the subscribe button. Because I'm gonna come up with amazing content on this channel. So do not miss out, do subscribe. And you can also reach out to me by following on Twitter, Instagram or LinkedIn. And you can also join my Discord server too. So I will make sure to put all these links in the description so you can check it out. So I will see you in the next video. Till then, keep learning, keep growing.